Hello everyone, welcome to the online lecture series on 8051 microcontroller. In the previous lecture, we had discussed on stack and subroutines on stack, and we had discussed a little bit of IO port programming. So we had actually looked into port 0 and then port 1. We looked into how can we configure port 0 in terms of input port, how can we configure it as an output port. So how does what process we need to follow in order to make the port to be input and then output port. So in the similar fashion, we had looked into port 1 as well. So how can we make port 1 as an input port as well as output port. And we had looked into the scenarios like why we are going to use the pull-up resistors in terms of port 0. Okay, so in today's discussion, we shall look into port 2 and then port 3, and then we shall look into some of the IO bit manipulations. Okay, so coming to the circuit of port 2 and 3, this is similar to our port 1 circuit diagram. So it is same as that itself. Okay, so here what we need to do is again we'll be having a D latch. So this is used for latching and then this is used for controlling. Okay, so now if I want to make my port as an input port, I need to send one to my internal bus and I need to enable the clock signals over here so that the output I'll be getting is 1 and then 0 here. Since there is a 0 over here, this in turn makes this particular NMOS transistor to be turned off. So this will be acting like an open switch. So at this particular point, with the use of internal pull-up resistor, the voltage level at this particular this thing will be logic 1. So that will be the VCC voltage. So since of because of that, the input bits whatever are coming, those input bits can be read over here at this particular read pin. Okay, so this is all this is how you are going to read the pins. So again, when it comes to writing down the pins, so first I need to send 0 in order to make my port to be working as an output port. So after that, I'll be sending what I'll be sending in the data, whichever you want to send, that you'll be sending to your DLS. So here we are sending the data that should be written to as a 0. So the output of DLS, what you are getting, it is going to be 0 and 1. Since here it is 1, this in turn it is going to turn on what? It is going to turn on this particular transistor. So the transistors will over here, it is going to act like an what? It is going to act like a closed switch. So the voltage level at this particular point, I'll be having what? I'll be having 0 volts. So that represents what? That represents logic 0. In a similar fashion, if I want to send 1, so I'll be sending my internal bus data to be 1. So the output of this particular D-latch, I'll be getting 1 and then 0. So since here it is 0, this will what this is going to be what this is going to be turned off. So it is going to act as an open switch. So at this particular point, I'll be having what? I'll be having a voltage which is equal to VCC because of this internal pull-up resistor. So since it is equal to VCC, I'll be considering that particular thing as logic 1. Okay, so this is what this is similar to my port 1. Okay, the working scenario is both the same for port 2 and then port 3 as well. So since the same circuit has been followed in terms of port 2 and then 3, so the working is same for both the ports. Okay, but the port 3 has some alternate uses. That is like we are having what? Since it is an 8-bit pin, 8-bit port. Okay, So we have they have divided in terms of what they have divided these particular 8-bit pins to be used for my alternate uses. Now if you look at this particular thing over here, the pin number 0 and the pin number 1, they have been used for what? Serial data communication, that is serial communication. So as we all know, serial communication in the sense we'll be sending the data in terms of serially. So again, it is dependent on what? It is dependent on the baud rate. Okay, so we'll be setting up the baud rate, that is that might be a 4800 baud per second, bits per second, or it can be 9600 bits per second. Okay, so based on that we are going to set up the baud rate, and then we are going to send the data in terms of what? We are going to send the data in terms of serially. So here the 0th bit, okay, the 0th bit of port 3 will be acting like as an receiver, and the first bit will be bit number 1 will be acting like as an transmitter over here. In the similar fashion, the port 3.2 and the associated special function register for these two particular pins is SBUF. Okay, and port 2, bit 2 and then bit 3 are being used as what? External interrupts. Okay, now interrupts, as we have seen, interrupts in the sense there is a small this thing. Suppose you might be having a hard reset button, so that reset will be working as what? It is going to be worked as the interrupt pin. So where it stops the working of our main program. So that means I'm interrupting the execution of the program. So though that's why we call those things as what? We call those things as interrupts. So this might be an hard interrupt, as well as this might be a signal coming from a certain source where I need to halt my program. So based on the condition what we can have, based on that condition we are going to halt the program. So this is somewhat interrupts are nothing but these things are nothing but these things are stop these things stops the execution of the program. And you can observe that these particular signals are active low signals. Okay, so here we are having at port 2, we are bit 2 we are having interrupt 0, and then at bit 3 we are having interrupt 1. So and the associated special function register is TCON.1 and then TCON.3. In the similar fashion, the other two have been bit 4 and then bit 5 have been used for what? They have been used for timer 0 and then timer 1, and the special function register associated with that will be TMOD. Okay, now since we are having an inbuilt ROM over in our 8051, but if you want to extend the read-only memory, then what we'll be doing, we'll be using some extra external memory. So I need to interface that external memory to my 8051 in order to write down the data and then read the data from the memory. So these particular pins, that is pin number 6 and then pin number 7, these are the two pins which are specially meant for interfacing with the external memory. So again, these two pins are what? These two pins are active low pins. So that means if I send 0, then only this pin will be active. If I send 1, then the pin will be what? The pin will be what? It will be inactive. Okay, so these are some of the alternate uses which are used for port 3. Okay, now let us look into IO bit manipulation programming here. Like manipulation programming in the sense, here we'll be looking into how actually we can program these IO pins. Okay, now as we had we have looked in terms of what are these IO ports and then how actually these IO ports are working. Now let us see how to program these particular pins so that I can what I can use these ports in order to write down the programs. Okay, now all the pins which are present in, since we are having totally 4 number of ports, each port is having 8 bits. Okay, So totally I'll be having how many bits? 8 into 4, so I'll be having 32 bits. All the 32 bits, that means all the pins in all the ports are what? They are bit addressable. So I can address a single bit. Okay, so we can access the entire 8 bits, or I can access only one single bit without altering any other bits which are present in that port. Now, for example, if I want to access the bit number or if I want to access the pin number 1 in port 1, okay, so I can make that only the pin number 1 of port 1 active, and then rest all the pins I can make it as inactive. So that is why all the pins, okay, all the pins in all the ports are bit addressable. They are not byte addressable, they are bit addressable. Okay, suppose if we want to access these single bit, okay, so what we can use is we can use the syntax set B. You can observe over here, set B x point y. So where x is what? This is going to be the port, and then this is going to be the pin number. Okay, as you can see here, you can see the example over here. Okay, now if you look at this, this represents what? This represents x, and then this represents my y. So this is what? This is my port number, and then this is my pin number. Okay, so here actually what we are making is, suppose if you take a look at, if you are having this particular port 1 over here, okay, so it is having all these 8 bits. Okay, so actually we are making this particular pin to go high. Okay, so this is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I'm making this particular pin of port 1 to be high. So I'm setting this particular pin to be high. So let us, in the similar fashion, we can have not only the single bit pins which are present in my ports. Okay, for that particular thing, I am having different types of instructions. Now, here you can observe set bit. This is what we had seen in the previous slide. So, I'll be setting the bit to be 1. So, we are making that particular bit to be high. Suppose if you want to make that bit to be low, so then I'll be using this particular instruction that we call it as clear, CLR. Okay, if you want to complement the bit, then we are having CPL. Okay, this is same as our Boolean expression complement what we are having over here. And then here we are having jump to the target if bit is 1. Okay, that is our JB. Jump to the target if bit is 0. Okay, so that is a jump if no bit. Okay, jump to the target if bit is equal to 1, and then clear the bit. Okay, so that means what? Jump if bit is high, and then clear. Okay, target here, what you can observe is the target is nothing but it is not any this thing, it is just what? It is just a label. Okay, label in the sense, suppose we will be calling different extra instructions, so we'll be labeling those set of instructions to be something like here, or we can call delay, something like that. So this target will be what? The target will be that particular label what we are having, it is going to be that. So here target in the sense, it is not going to look for it has to achieve this, something like that. So if a bit is high, then it is going to jump to the, it is going to jump to that particular label. If bit is not high, it is going to jump that particular label. If both the results get false, then it is going to jump to the next instruction. Okay, so now if you look at let us look at some of the programs. Now, if you look at this particular program, okay, what is the program? Complementing port 1.2 continuously. So here we need to write down a program which complements the bit number 2 or the pin number 2. That means pin number 3 in port 1. Okay, because why? Because our port, this thing will start from 0, 0, 1, 2. That means this particular, this thing will be what? It is going to be pin number 3 of port 1. Okay, I need to complement the pin number 3 of port 1 every time after some delay. Okay, that means it should keep on complementing all the time. So one way of doing is what? One way of doing is I can use my complement instruction what we had studied. Okay, so I'll be calling that complement. So I'll have complement port 1.2. And then I'll be calling some delay, and then I'll be using this short jump to go back to what? To go back to this particular thing. So this is what, this is the label. Okay, this back what we are having, this is actually the label. This is what, this is what it is, the target. Okay, so it is going, this is going to be completely in terms of what, it is going to be completely in terms of loop. So first, if port 1.2 is 0 after some delay, again it will become what? It is going to become 1, and then again after some delay it is going to become what? It is going to become 0. Here delay is what? Here since we are using this A call over here, A call is nothing but what? It is going to be a subroutine program since we are calling absolute call over here. So this particular delay program is a subroutine program. That program we have not written over here. Okay. If you want to add delay, then again we need to write a subroutine program delay, which is which should start at some different address location, and then it has to, by using a DJNZ, decrement jump if not equal to 0, using that we are going to add the delay. Okay, so this particular program, it is going to, in the similar fashion we can write it in terms of a different way. Okay, now if you look at this particular program, here we have used this complement, but instead of using this complement, what we are using over here, I am using set bit and then clear bit. Okay, set and then clear, set and then clear. So I'm using this particular set, first I'm setting and then I'm adding delay, and then again I'm clearing and then adding delay, then I'm jumping back. Okay, this is what we are going to, this is what we are doing. Set, delay, clear, delay, and then loop back. Set, delay, clear, delay, and then loop back. This is how it is going to execute. Okay, so now let us look into another program. Okay, here we are having another program, that is what, I need to generate a square wave of a 50% duty cycle to the bit 0 of port 1. Okay, so here I need to generate a square wave of 50% duty cycle on bit 0 of port 1. Okay, so here actually what we are doing, if you want 50% duty cycle in a sense, so I need a wave which is exactly something like this. Okay, so this is what it is going to be. So if this particular, this thing is 1 nanosecond, okay, if this is 1 nanosecond, or let me take the whole this thing to be 2 nanosecond, from here till here, then this particular time should be what? It should be 1 nano. So this is what it is, what it is, 50%. Okay, that means it should be equally half, this part, this much part, and then this much part. It is going to be what? It is going to be equal, this much part and then this much part. So what I can do, I can make use of only one single delay. See here, this delay, this particular delay, and then this particular delay is going to be same. So I can make use of, I can write on a single delay program, and then I can make use of that particular delay program continuously. Now here, if you look at this thing, this is going high over here. From 0 it is going to 1. Okay, from 1 again it is going to be 0 over here after some delay. So what I can do is, first I need to set this, and then what, and then clear over here. That is why set port 1 with bit 0, pin 0, okay, give some delay, clear, and then again give delay, and then again what you should do, you should loop back. So that is why here it is going to jump back, and then again it is going to execute. So this is going to be continuously done. So that's why I'll be getting a square wave with 50% duty cycle. One more similar fashion. This is how we had looked over here in this particular example, right? Using complement. So here complement, delay, and then loop back. So every time it is going to complement after giving some delay. So this is one of the example how we can use our ports in terms of what bit addressable, or I can use how I can use my port to be a single bit operation. Okay, so now let us look into another port. So how can we check the input bit? How can you perform checking of an input bit? Basically, checking is being done by using two instructions, that is our JNB and then JB. So JNB is nothing but jump if no bit, and then jump if bit. So here, if bit is 0, then it is going to jump to the level which we have specified. Here, if bit is 1, then it is going to jump to the level which we are going to specify. That means what here, actually here, if it is getting jumped by checking the bit, the value of bit, then that means what, I am checking the values of some particular input ports, what I'm having over here. I'm checking whether 0 or 1. So that is why these particular instruction, these two set of instructions can be used in order to check an input bit. Okay. So these particular pins instructions can be used on all the ports, that is our port 0, 1, and then 2, and then 3. But most of the time it is going to be used in terms of what, it is going to be used in terms of 0, 1, and 2. Because since I have some alternate uses of port 3, most of the time we won't be going for using checking of an input bit to my port 3. Since it will be used for other purposes like our serial communication, interrupts, and then timers, and as well. Okay, this is one way of doing like checking in terms of we'll be loading those things in terms of port number, and then checking by using JB and then JNB instruction. We are going to check whether it is going to be 0 or 1. One more way of doing is, I can load the particular thing into my carry flag, and then I can use another set of instruction, that is jump if carry and then jump if no carry, that is my JC and then JNC. So based on that, even I can use my carry flag as my bit for my checking of an input bit. Okay, so now let us see. So these are some of the examples. So here you can observe the whole byte of data is being moved over here. Okay, and then from accumulator, I am checking whether if my port is particularly 1 or not. Here target, again here target is nothing but it is going to be label, and then again if jump if bit, and then how we can perform my carry operation, that is move C, 2.4, and then again I can make use of that complement and all those things. Okay, let us look into some of the programs. Let us look into examples. So we are having an example over here. Write a program to perform the following. So first, what we need to do, first I should keep on monitoring port 1.2 until it becomes high. Okay, so this port 1.2 is going to be what? It is going to be my input port, right? So this is going to be an input port. Since I'm checking, okay, since I'm checking whether it is going to be high or not, so this particular this thing will be what? It is going to be an input port. So next condition is what? When port 1.2 becomes high, I need to write 45 hexa to what? Port 0. So second condition is what? I need to write 45 hexa should be written where? It should be written to port 0. Okay, now send a high to low signal to port 2.3. So for port 2.3, I need to send what? I need to send a high to low signal. That means I need to send a signal which is something like this. Okay, so how can we write this? So first, what I should do is that if you look at this thing, since it is making it as an input port, so first I should make sure how we are going to make our port as an input by writing 1 to it. Okay, so this is a single bit, so I can use my bit addressable this thing, and so I'll be writing what? I can write this using my instruction, that is my set B. Okay, so by set B port 1.2, I'll be making this as an input port, and then here I need to write this particular data to port 0, so I should load my accumulator with this particular value. Okay, after that, what we are going to do, this is what? This is initial conditions what we are going to have. Okay, once these initial conditions are being set, what we can do is that I can start executing my program. So how we had said, I need to check whether it is high or not. So again, checking an input bit, we will be using JB or JNB. Since here they have said it is going to be high, I can use what? I'll be using my jump rate. Okay, if it is high, then you move on to next. Okay, now let us look into the program. Now if you look at this, okay, so here what we have done, here we have made my port 1.2 be as input port. Since I need to send data over here, so I have loaded that particular value to my accumulator, and then I am keep on checking. Okay, so here what we are going to do, jump if no bit. If bit is not present, again you go back where? If it is 0, you come back here. If it is 1, then only I need to perform a. So what I'm doing, I'm using JNB. Okay, that is why here we are using what? Here we are using JNB, because if it is 0, then it should be in continuous loop. Otherwise, if it is 1, then it should perform these operations. That is why I'll be using JNB, and then I'm making it into be continuous loop. If this is false, okay, if this thing becomes high and then this becomes false, then what I should do, I should send 45 hexa to port 0. So port accumulator is having my value, that is 45 hexa. Then what we are doing, we are moving that value to port 0, and then I need to send a high to low pulse. Okay, so high set bit, here we have made it as high, and then again we have made it as what? Clear. So high to low pulse we have sent. So all these operations, what they had asked for, that we have executed. What we have executed in terms of this particular set of instructions. Okay. So now let us look. Okay. Now we are having one more program. What actually they are telling? Assume that port 2.3 is an input. Okay. Now this is again an input, and represents the condition of an one. If it goes high, okay, again high they are telling. Okay, this is high. That means logic one. Okay, it means that one is hot. Monitor the bit continuously. So that means I need to monitor this particular pin P2.3. Whenever it goes high, send a high to low pulse to port 1.5 to turn on the buzzer. So again here what? Again we are checking same JNB we will be using. Okay. So before that I need to make this particular pin to be input pin. So what I'll be using, I'll be making set bit P2.3, right? So I'll be making this as an what? I'll be making this particular pin to be input port that we had not written over here. Now if you look at this again, what jump if no bit, then UP is being loop. If it is 0, if it is 1, what I should send? I should send a high to low pulse to port 1.2, 1.5. So what you'll be using? I'll be using one thing to be set bit. So after that I'll be using clear. Okay, so set bit clear. Okay, after that I should go where? I should be keep on repeating this particular program. So I'll be keep on checking whether it is going to be high or not. So after that again it is going to be in a complete loop. So these are a little bit of the examples what we can have over here. Okay, so in the this is all. Let us wind off this particular lecture, and from in the next lecture we shall look into some of the assembly level programs using loops. Let us look into some of the examples. How can we perform? How can we write down they have given. Okay, thank you.